Welcome to a special video here. In this video, I will talking about the thinking process and system design workflow techniques that you can apply to your project. If your project is about the computer-based monitoring and control, industrial automation systems, microcontroller and embedded system applications, or another type of the project that related to the electronic circuitsMicrocontroller circuits and computer programs. Hopefully, this video can help you to complete your project. Remember, your project composed of three main things: document, presentation, and the source code. Now, let's get started with the example. I start with the garden tree like this. What you think when you see the tree like this?If you are the gardener or you are the tree lover, you know about the tree, right? You know the tree requires some water, some fertilizer or sunlight, whatever, depend on the type of the tree. In this example, I will choose some sensors to measure some environment parameters. For example, moisture, humidity, temperature, and light intensity.That kind of sensors can be used to measure some environment parameters of the tree. When we know the parameter of the tree, we can control that parameters. For example, if we know the soil too dry, we can feed some water. If we know about today is very, very low light, we can make a light by turn on the lamp, something like that. To control the environmentYou have to choose some appropriate actuator. For example, a pump to feed some water, a valve to feed some fertilizer, a fan to make an airflow to dry your plant. For example, today is the raining day, and your tree don't love the moisture. You have to turn on the fan to dry the tree, something like that. Perhaps you require to protect.Your tree from a bird. In this case, you have to install a motion sensor to detect the bird, and you can make some special sound to drive out the bird fly away. There are no limitation about the idea. You can decide whatever you like. After that, choose the appropriate sensor, appropriate actuator, and make things happen by writing some code. Before moving to the next step,Let I introduce you about the big picture one again. This system will show you about the big picture of our system that you can understand overall of the system. We start from the tree and the pot here. We can install some sensor, for example, moisture, humidity, temperature, light intensity, and you can add another sensor, for example, motion sensor and rain detector.You can also add some actuator, for example, pump, valve, lamp, buzzer, fan. All the sensor and actuator are connected to the microcontroller. It means that the microcontroller can receive some data from the sensor. The microcontroller can control your actuator. In this system, the microcontroller is connected to the internet.It means that it can exchange its data to your application. For example, if you would like to turn on the lamp, you can click the button. If you would like to see some temperature, you can pick up your mobile phone and see at the indicator or the gate, something like that. Hopefully, you understand the idea of our project and think about your own. Think about how many sensors, how many actuators,and how to design your application to make the user happy. Okay, first of all, let's I define my project name. In this example, I give it a name AutoPot 2020. The AutoPot can grow my plant automatically because it has some sensor, it has some actuator.It can sense some environment parameters and can control everything. Now let's see the system overview. In this example, there are two main things that we are thinking about. The first one is the system, in this case, the garden tree and the pot. Another thing is the application we call the IoT application. You have to link between the system, I mean the tree or the pot, to the application, in this case, the browser. In this example, you can see here we have some indicator, just like a gate. We have some control, for example, a button like this. When you click, you can control something. We can control some actuator using the knob in terms of the numerical control like this. For example, make the fan rotate around 50% or something like that, you can use the knob. Let's start from the big picture like this and move on to the detail of each element. Let's think about sensors. As you know, sensors are the electronic devices that turn the physical parameters to electrical parameters. For example, if you try to measure the light intensity, when the light go up, you get some lower resistance, something like that. Or if you try to measure the humidity, for example, when the humidity in the air go higher, you get higher voltage. In general, the sensors can be classified into two groups. The first one is the sensor that gives you some analog signal, just like a voltage or current or resistance, something like that. The second group is the sensor that can give you just high and low. For example, 0 volt, 5 volt or something like that, or 0 ohm and infinity ohm. In this system, there are edge sensors. As you can see here, it starts from moisture, humidity, temperature, light intensity. These four sensors are analog sensor. It means that it can give us the voltage in this example. The two here, the rain sensor and motion sensor, it will give us the logic. For example, if right now it's raining, the sensor give you a logic high. If no rain, the sensor give logic low. In the same way for the motion sensor. For example, if the sensor detect the bird, the dog, or the cat close to your plant, that sensor give you logic high. It means that you can detect something in front or nearby the tree. Another two of the sensor indicate it work like switches. It means that switch on the microcontroller board or switch that install in your pod. In this case, I decide to use that two switches as a fan controller and the lamp controller. Sometimes you are working near the plant or the tree and you would like to turn on the fan, you can press the button as well as you can turn on and turn off by pressing the button as well. Okay, this is the system overview and we define the sensors that will be used in our system. This sensor will be linked to the circuit simulator. I will explain you later. Now, let's talking about the sensor simulations. As you know, in the simulation world, all the sensors can be simulated by the signal sources. For example, the variable resistor or potentiometer. You can use the function generator. For the digital signals, you can generate the signal using the simple switches. And you can also use the function generator to generate that digital signal as well. As you know, the types of the sensors can be divided into two groups. Analog output sensors and digital output sensors. Now, let's talking about the analog output sensors. Analog output means the output of that sensor can be varying from some number to another number. In this case, from 0 volt to 3.3 volt. In this system, we have four sensors that will be give us the analog signal. In our case, we have four sensors: the moisture, humidity, temperature, and light intensity. We can simulate this sensor using the simple potentiometer like this. As you can see here, I use the port number 0 and define it as a moisture sensor. And another one, for example here, the port number 3, I define it as the light intensity sensor. In the real world, you may think this potentiometer can be replaced by an LDR. The output of the potentiometers or our sensors here represented by the terminal with the MCU and the pin name of the MCU. It means that these terminals will be connected to the MCU to make the MCU know the change of the voltage of our sensor. In the simulation world, I mean in the Proteus, you can use your mouse to click to change the resistance. It means that change the voltage that sent to the CPU. When the MCU know about the change here, it know about the temperature change in this case. Okay, that it for the analog output sensor. Think about it in your project. Think about how to define the potentiometers to whatever you like. It depends on your project. Now, let's talking about the digital output sensors. The digital means the output of that sensor can be only two stages, high and low, or 1 and 0. We call the logic output, right? In this example, we have four sensors that can give us the digital output. The first one is motion sensor. It used to detect the motion nearby your plant or nearby your tree. For example, when a bird fly in and try to eat your garden tree, when you detect it, you can make some strange sound to drive out the bird. The second one is the rain detector or rain sensor. If today you detect they are raining, the water feeding process should be turned off. The third one and the fourth one is the basic switches, the push button switches. They are used to control the lamp and the fan. As I explained before, the lamp in this case used to heat up your plant and also used to give it the light for the plant. You can control the lamp manually by pressing that switch number 2. For the fan control, we use switch number 3. In this example, the fan is used to make airflow. For example, if today you know that there are a lot of humidity in the air, you can turn on the fan to dry out the air. Or sometime after the raining, if you would like to dry out your plant, you can turn on the fan. And also, you can turn on the lamp to make it dry more faster. Like the analog output sensor, or the digital output sensor here will be connected to the MCU pin. It means that the MCU know what happened in our system. For example, if you would like to know about the motion, you can check the logic status on the switch number 0, right? And when the CPU know about the status of switch number 0, the CPU or the MCU will send that data to your application. And your application can do something, for example, send some command to the MCU to ask MCU, please make the strange sound to drive out the bird or something like that. Okay. Hopefully, this presentation make you understand the concept of how to apply the basic switches in the simulation. Think about this and apply to your project. I don't know about your project, but hopefully, this circuit help you to understand the design process and thinking process that I try to present you. Think about this circuit. Think about your circuit simulator, the Proteus one, and try to complete your circuit. Try to complete your project. Try to apply these devices and make it interesting. Now, let's talking about the actuators. As you know, the actuators are used to convert the electrical parameter to the physical parameters. In our system here, we have 5 actuator. They are pump, valve, fan, light, and buzzer. You know by its name, the pump is used to feed some water to the garden plant. The valve is used to feed some fertilizer or some chemical. The fan is used to make an airflow to dry your plant or your tree. The light is used to heat your tree or can be used to generate the light for your plant. And finally, the buzzer is used to make the special sound to drive out the bird. In this system, the pump and the valve can be controlled by sending the signal on and off, while the fan, the light, and the buzzer are driven by PWM signal. You will see later what it means by that. In this system, the pump and the valve are designed to be controlled by the on-off control algorithm. It means that if you would like to turn it on, just send logic 1 to the driver circuit. And the another three devices here, the fan, the light, and the buzzer, are designed to be controlled by the PWM signals or pump with modulation signals. Why we need that? Because talking about the fan, we would like to control the fan speed. Increasing the ratio of PWM signal, it means increase the speed of the fan. When you see on the light, in this case can be controlled the intensity, the light intensity. Why we need that? Because talking about the fan, we would like to control the fan speed. Increasing the ratio of PWM signal, it means increase the speed of the fan. When you see on the light, in this case can be controlled the intensity, the light intensity. The last one is the buzzer. The buzzer can be controlled using the PWM as well. If you would like to increase the frequency of the sound, you can increase the frequency of PWM signal. Or if you would like to increase the power of the sound, you can increase the percent duty ratio of the PWM signal. There is another type of the actuator driver, the analog input actuator. For example, if you would like to increase the fan speed, you can increase the voltage. Or you can increase the light intensity by increase the current or something like that. That kind of actuator are not used in this project because it needs the analog control. In this project, I will talking about the digital control. Everything, I mean all the signal controls, must be the digital signal. As I explained, both on off and PWM signal is composed of two states, on and off, in different time, different frequency. Hopefully you understand my design and my idea here. It is a good time to think about your project one again. Which one can be used, which one cannot. How many actuators that can be applied into your system. Let's go in more detail about the actuator. Actuator simulations. The same technique, same idea compared to the sensor simulation that we already discussed previously. All of the actuators used in this project can be simulated by the basic electronics and electrical devices. Let's start with the first device, the pump. The pump can be driven by the relay like this, as you see in the circuit. Can be driven by a transistor. And as you know, a transistor can be driven by a logic that sent from a CPU. In this circuit, if you see from the left to the right hand side here, when the CPU sends the logic high, the transistor turn on, the relay active, and the motor will be turned on. Now let's take a look at the valve driver circuit. In this example, we use the same technique, the transistor and the relay. For example, in the current time, if you would like to turn off the valve, you can send the logic low to the transistor. The transistor turn off and the relay will be inactive. No current flow and the valve will be turned off. Now let's move to the fan controller circuit here. As you can see, the circuit quite simple. It composed of just only one transistor and one resistor. The resistor connected to the MCU. To control the fan, the MCU sent the PWM signal to turn on and turn off transistor with the high frequency. That high frequency make the fan rotate continuously. And we can change the speed of the fan by changing the duty cycle ratio of the PWM signal. For the light or the lamp driver circuit, we will use the same circuit that you see before, one transistor and one resistor. The control technique will be applied the same way, same thing. The MCU sends the PWM signal to turn on and turn off the transistor with the high frequency. For example, 50 Hz. The lamp here will be turned on and turned off with the high frequency as well. And we can see the light up. The intensity of the light can be controlled by changing the PWM signal. I mean, changing the duty cycle ratio. The last actuator here, the buzzer. The buzzer here working just like a speaker, the computer speaker, mobile phone speaker, something like that. It means that it can generate varied frequency of the sound. High frequency, low frequency, whatever. That frequency can be controlled by changing the PWM signal that you send to the transistor. For example, if you would like to make the high frequency sound, just generate the high frequency of PWM signal. For example, 5 kHz, 10 kHz, or something like that. Now, let's see on the circuits at the same time. Once again, the pump and the valve will be driven by on-off control technique. The fan, the lamp, and the buzzer will be driven by PWM control technique. And you can see here, all the transistors here are driven by the MCU pin. For example, if you see on the wall driver, that transistor connect to the pin number 9 of the MCU. Or you can say that it connects to the LED 0 in our circuit, in the simulation circuit. You can check the circuit detail in the Proteus circuit simulation. Now let's compare the circuits side by side. The circuit between our design and the circuit that we will use in the circuit simulator, I mean in the Proteus. You can see here, I add a NOT gate to the transistor here. Between the MCU terminal LED 1 and the resistor here. The circuit, in this case, we use from the LED driver. But the LED driver circuit working as active low circuit, we need to turn the active low to active high. That's a reason why I add the NOT gate between the CPU pin and the resistor. Okay, you can see here, all four circuits already the same thing. The pin that connected to the LED require a NOT gate to turn from active low to active high. One more thing about the wall circuit driver here. In the simulator, I not use the wall. I use the lamp interface. Because I think it easier to see the status of the wall. For example, when the wall turn on, we can see the light. However, in the simulation circuit, for choosing the device like that, you can use another device if you like. But for me, I love this way. For the circuit below, the fan and the lamp driver, it is a good idea to use the fan and the lamp like this. Because when you see on the fan, you would like to check the speed of the fan. As well as for the lamp, you have to see the intensity of the lamp. These two devices can show you the variation depend on the PWM signal that you apply. And sure, for the buzzer, you have to use the buzzer because you would like to play the sound to your computer speaker. Once again, in the simulation world, there are no limitation of choosing the electronic devices. You can pick one that you like and try to make it work. Try to control them. Try to present how they work. However, all devices or circuits that you see here. Some circuit can be used to your project, some circuit cannot be. So think about your project and try to find the appropriate devices. Try to find the appropriate circuit for your project. And that's it for the actuator simulation technique. Now, let's consider about our circuit in depth detail. To be sure you can read the circuit and understand how it works and can modify for your project. As you know, the microcontroller is a small computer. It means that you can write a program to make it work. In this class, you can use the real hardware or the simulation system using the Proteus. Both systems work the same thing, the same way. Working with the simulator, it's more easier, more faster, especially when you try to debug your program or try to analyze your circuit. After everything in our system completely work, I mean everything work together, both hardware and software, you can turn your simulation circuit to the real world. Let's take a look closely on our circuit one again. In this circuit, you can see we have a microcontroller. We have the circuit that used to generate the voltage source. In this case, we use potentiometer. Okay, the potentiometer can be changed by use the mouse to click or click the arrow up and down here. The voltage output at the terminal here can be changed from 0 to 3.3 volt in this case. Another circuit is the switched circuit like this. It used to generate the digital data. Okay. This circuit is connected as active load circuit. What it mean by that? It means when you place the switch, the output will be 0 or low. If you release the switch, the output will be high. You can hold down the switch by placing the red arrow here. The switch will be hold down like that. Another circuit is the LED driver. Just like a switch, just like a switches, the LED here are connected as active load circuit. It means that if the CPU send the logic data to this terminal, it means that if the CPU want to turn on the LED, the MCU must be send the logic low to this terminal. Low mean on, high mean off in this circuit. We also have the COM pin that used to communicate to the ECC UART web socket. It means that we connect to that software for doing a web-based application. As you remember, web browser connect to the ECC web socket. The web socket connect to the Proteus. That's a reason why you can exchange data from web browser to the circuit. This component, the COM pin, very important in this case. We have another devices here. For example, the oscilloscope. If you would like to use, you can. You can change the terminal. Okay, and also we have two terminals here used to analyze the data flow between the serial port. In the most case, these devices are used for debugging. The thing that you have to know is that the terminal name here will be connected to another. Just remember this word, the same name connect together. What it mean by that? It means that, for example, here, if you see on the ADC2, its name, it looks like an input, right? It means that someone will send some analog data to this pin, the pin number 4. Where it is, you can see where is the ADC2. In this case here, the port number 2. Or when you try to see about the LED number 3, you can see here, someone will send the logic data to the RL3. And you can find where is the LED3. And you can see on the microcontroller here, the LED3. See, the microcontroller send out the logic to pin number 7. for the buzzer here. Okay, terminal name bus connected to this pin. BU success here. Okay, this will generate the PWM signal and drive the buzzer. Okay, this is the function generator. You can use it if you like. In this case, connect to nothing. I just put for the debugging. One more thing that I would like to tell you that all the devices here require the CPU power. I mean, your computer need to be do some more work if you turn it on. If in that time you don't want to use it, you should exclude from your project. How to exclude or include? For example, in this time, I don't want to use these two terminals here. I can exclude it by right click. Okay, choose edit property. And you can see here, exclude from simulation. Just check if it means that. Just like a delete, but just leave it be, right? Just like a comment in computer program. Exclude mean comment out. Okay, this one as well, I just exclude. Okay. Oscilloscope as well, you can right click and edit property and exclude if you don't use that it for the general use of the Proteus circuit simulation. When you, for example here, let I turn on the terminal number one. And when you run here, you get this window, right? This window is just like I use for debugging. You can see in this time the switch number 2 turn on. I just turn it off. See? This message actually will be sent to web browser. But sometime you can use it if you like to see what happened. And for example, if you close it, it gone. When you run it again, nothing happened. It's still include in your project if you see here, right? It's still there. You not include it. But when you run, wait this. If you get some situation like this, the terminal, the oscilloscope or whatever, if that window did appear, you can go to the debug, okay? And should reset the debug pop-up window. Or in the running time, you can go to debug and choose which one you would like to open again. In this case, the visual terminal, okay, the console, and that's it. Okay, however, in this time, I don't want to use it. I just exclude it. Okay, that's it for the use of the circuit simulation. It is a good idea to design and write your circuit by your own, okay? And it is a good idea to use the terminal because it makes your circuit more clean, more easier to read, right? Let's talking a bit about the additional circuit here. Okay, the circuit that we use just like an actuator. For example, the motor, the lamp, or something like that. This one is a special one that I give you an example. I don't know about your project, but it is an example. For example here, the motor you add a pump here can be controlled by the LED one. Once again, the terminal name here, LED one. If you see on the microcontroller, you can see here, LED one. Pin number 12. LED one. Connect to the LED one of the LED here, and also it connect to the NOT gate here to drive your pump. Okay, for the PWM signal control devices here, we have PWM 1, PWM 0, and buzzer. Once again, the same name connect together. Just take a look on PWM 1 and PWM 0 here. You can see PWM 1 and 0 connect to these pins. this circuit you can download from the GitHub. Try to modify, try to think about, try to put some label, try to check how it works, and modify to fit to your project. Hopefully this help. Now let's talking about the engineering documentation. We can call the technical document the very important thing for engineers and very important for you. Now you try to build your own project, your own system, and you would like to explain another one know what you are doing, how your system works, how many functions or features that your system can do, how to use your system, how to build your system, or something like that. You have to create your high quality document. Normally, the engineering document composed of at least one drawing that explains how many components in your system. For example, if you are working with the electronic circuit, you have to start from drawing a block diagram. How many blocks in your system, and each block can be explained as a circuit. In that circuit, you have the electronic devices. For example, the resistor. You have to define the value of the resistor. I mean the resistance. If you have transistor, you have to define the part number. And to explain another one understand how the circuit is designed, you have to explain in terms of the equation using the Ohm laws or something like that to be sure the reader understand how the circuit works and how it is designed. Now let me share you and guide you about how to create the high quality drawing, how to create the high quality document in terms of the drawing here. I am here in the Microsoft Visio. As you know, the Microsoft Visio is the software that used to create the drawing, especially in the engineering drawing or another drawing. There are a lot of library, including the electronic devices. In my drawing here, all the thing that you see, I write it by myself. Start from a dot, start from a line, start from shape or something like that, and then connect them together. You can find the library if you like, but using the library sometimes it's hard to maintain, it's hard to edit. Okay, pay your time to draw everything by yourself. I think it's easier to change to edit. Let me show you what I mean by that. For example here, I would like to copy this circuit. The pump circuit here. I just control C. And then I open up the Microsoft Word here. And paste the circuit here. You can see. You can complete the drawing. The high quality drawing. You can expand it. You can resize it. And it's still sharp line. Okay. See. You can expand. You can resize whatever you like. Because the drawing in the visual is not the picture, it's just a vector. Another one is that if you would like to edit something, for example, I would like to change the color of the box here. I just double click from the Microsoft Word here. After that, the Microsoft Visio open up and you can edit whatever you like. For example, I feel to color the green color like this. Just hit save. And close the Visio, and then your document already updated. You can change anything. Okay, that is how I prefer you to use the software like Visio or another that can draw the circuit or can draw your block diagram. You are working with the circuit. Sometimes you working with another software just like a Proteus like this. And if you copy the circuit from the another software by screen capture or just convert it to the image file. And for example here, I copy and I back to my Microsoft Word and paste here. You see? You can resize it if you like. And compare the top one and below one. Which one should get the high score, the higher score? For example, this is a student A, this is a student B. Sure. This one get 5, this one get 10. Because when we are talking about the document, talking about drawing, we would like, we prefer to see the high quality drawing, right? Talking about the writing, I would like to see how you write, how you explain in terms of the engineering, in terms of equation or something like that. One more thing that I would like to tell you that, for example here, you have the drawing and you try to explain something, right? For example, this is the engineering document, something like this. And you have to change the font to the template, for example, Times New Roman, something like that. Be sure your font type, I mean font family and font size must be the same. It means that here you can see it is the Times New Roman 11. This one should be the same. You can see. Sometimes you change the font is very small. It hard to read, or sometimes it very big. The same document should use the same font type and font size. Okay, please keep in mind. Please pay your attention to your writing and your drawing here. Okay, that's it for my suggestion about how to build the high quality document. Hopefully you can do it. And I am waiting to see your amazing work. Take care and goodbye.